I think you watched my first video. So this is the second update regarding the making of 3D model using cardboards. In this video we are going to make rhombohedron. This is pyretohedron and trapezohedron, three new ones, and we will revise two models, that is tetrahexahedron and trisoctahedron. I am going to discuss that where the mistake was made, what was the reasons behind making a bad model. Yeah, you can say how we can make a perfect model of trisoctahedron or tetrahexahedron. I am starting from the trisoctahedron. So this is, you can see, you know, this is what a isosceles triangle. ठीक है, isosceles triangles means two sides. These two sides are of same length, but third one is different. The major point, a major property required for making the perfect trisoctahedron or tetrahexahedron, these two angles are very important. As low as these angles you will do, okay, you will get the more perfect, because here you can see, now because it is trisoctahedron, so first we make one face of the octahedron and divided by three face of this isosceles. So first make isosceles, then make a face of the octahedron. Okay, put it. Now you will, how we can join, we will join like this. See, the slopes are very high. Why? Because this gap was also very high. If this gap is, to reduce this gap, what we can do, we can make the this angle, these angles slight low angle. Okay, now look these three, these are also isosceles. Okay, these two sides are isosceles side, third one is of not, have not same length as the isosceles sides. Okay, so join them. Now see, and this is the, this angle is much gentle than the earlier one. Okay, so now join them. A perfect face of the trisoctahedron. Okay, so by using such kind of isosceles triangles, such isosceles triangles means very low angle, isosceles sides are at low angle, so you can make three, put like this, join them. Okay, and then join the fourth end also. One, two, three, join, put together using cardboard or cello tape, and then join fourth one. Then you will get the perfect trisoctahedron. So now move on, and this one is the tetrahexahedron. Start doing this also. See, 1, 2, 3 and 4. All are isosceles, no apex will come. The major problem is here, no apex is coming. But we need what? Apex, some raising point. So this isosceles are imperfect. Okay, now let's see secants which are used for the making of the trisoctahedron. So now if you are going to use such kind of scale, such kind of ISO scale which have low angle, okay. Okay, this is low angle, but we are unable to what? Put the fourth one. There is no space for the fourth one. So, again some kind of problem. So, for that, you need, so now, these, all three are the equilateral triangles. So, I think this was used in here, this one, it was not perfect for making the trisoctahedron. We have seen during the trisoctahedron and it giving the steep slope, and here it is perfectly flat. Okay, so we can't use this one, so rejected. Now this one is going not giving space for the putting fourth face. So this one is something greater angle. So this angle is steeper, means bigger than this one. So during making, you can do one thing. First make a square, okay, and cut it perfectly in four pieces. Then just this angle shift 1 or 2 degrees both side. I think 2 degrees is sufficient, okay, from the face of square. Just shift 2 degrees only, then you will get the perfect face of the tetrahexahedron. Okay, I am going to make it in front of you. Tetrahexa face, this is tetrahedra, a kind of four facing isosceles triangles. See, made up of four isosceles triangles, put them together like this and join, it will looks like a strip of the fourth geometry. Okay, then join both end together. Wow, very nice and very beautiful. Next one is rhombohedra, means calcite. Consist of how many faces? 6 faces, rhombic faces, and it is the belongs to the hexagonal system here. For that you need such kind of the rhombic shape cardboards. Okay, so what is this rhombic shape means? All axis should be of equal length and opposite angle should have equal amount. So angle, opposite angle and length of the sides should be equal. Put two together. put together one joint. So it is a perfect rhombohedra, okay, that is called calcite. In next one, two are remaining from the isometric system, that is trapezohedron and pyramidohedron. So first we are going to take trapezohedron, okay. So for trapezohedron, you need trapezium, okay. The main feature or main property of this trapezium is these two sides should be equal and these two sides should be equal, okay. Angle is different things, but you have to make such trapezium where these two sides are equal and it is not at 90 degree, slightly inclined, okay. Then you will able to make the trapezohedron. Other just put them and join side by side like this. So I am telling these four, if four sides are equal, then you will put like this, then you will able to all sides will be of equal length, okay. Second thing, if they are at 90 degree, then you will not get this gap. You have to get this gap, then the point will be raised here, apex of the trapezohedron, okay. You will get from where axis is passing, okay. Now this is the one face of trapezium. In trapezohedron, you know there is 24 faces. So you need such kind of a face consist of the a piece consist of four trapezium. You need six, okay. After that, some portion was already made, so I am going to put like this, put them together. Now you can see a perfect trapezohedron. Next model is pyramidohedron. The pyramidohedron is made up of 12 faces. It is a closed form and is made up of 12 faces, and each face is a pentagon. So if we are discussing about pentagon, so pentagon are two types. First one is considered as regular pentagon and second one is considered as irregular pentagon. And as per definition, regular pentagon have all sides and all angle, means angle are equal and sides are equal. But in irregular pentagon, it is not defined that ki all sides are will be irregular or all angle will be not same. So but the basic property of the pyramidohedron is it consists of 12 irregular pentagons. So can only make a perfect pyramidohedron using such kind of pentagons. For making this such kind of pentagon, you first make a regular pentagon. Okay. Then this angle, just change this side, take some, means increase this angle. Which angle? This angle of a regular pentagon to 5 degree or 10 degree this side and 5 to 10 degree this side. Okay, increase. Means total 10 to 20 degree between these two lines. And keep the sides length is same. Similarly, you have drawn the regular pentagon, then you have the these sides also. Just draw the parallel lines to these. Amount is same, side amount means four sides should be have equal length, and just draw the parallel lines. When we make this angle open, so these will be more space to this side. So this side will be only the have different length in comparison to all other four sides. The key parameter of the this pentagon, that one side is of different value and other all are of same. And remember, now put two together, so there you can make how many? Six pairs. So at least you make five pair. So I told you earlier that making pyramidohedron is not easy task because it have 12 pentagon and pentagon have 5 sides. Okay, this one is the perfect one, pyramidohedron. So in this video we made trapezohedron, pyramidohedron, rhombohedron and revision of the tetrahexahedron and trisoctahedron. We made trapezohedron, perfect trapezohedron. Another was perfect pyramidohedron. Pyramidohedron looks like this only. Okay. Then we made revision of tetrahexahedron, revised crystal trisoctahedron. Watching this part 1 and part 2, you will be able to make first beryl belonging to hexagonal system, zircon belonging to tetragonal system, again rhombohedron belonging to the hexagonal, next one is cube belonging to isometric system, rhombododecahedron, beautiful and perfect one, rhombododecahedron belonging to isometric system, again tetrahexahedron belonging to the cubic system. This is the trapezohedron belonging to cubic system. This one is the pyramidohedron belonging to cubic system. This is the trisectahedron belonging to cubic system, and this one is octahedron belonging to cubic system, and this is the tetrahedron belonging to cubic system. Thank you.